The strategy of Rio is very simple. It's about building what we describe as a world-class asset portfolio. What we mean by a world-class asset portfolio is really assets which are low-cost, large, with lots of growth opportunities. And let me give you two very simple examples. One is our iron ore business in the Pilbara, which is really a world-class asset, or our smelter, or aluminium smelter in the secondary in Canada. As we speak, we have three major growth projects in the pipeline. The first one is a project called Silvergrass, which is about strengthening the quality of the product that we produce in the Pilbara, mainly for the Chinese market. And that's well underway and should be completed end of this year. The second one is a project called Amrun, which is about bauxite. It's around $1.9 billion, and it's in Australia as well. It's about bauxite, primarily for the Chinese alumina and aluminium market. And the last project that is underway, but it's a more remote project, it will take 5 years to build, is our project in Mongolia, which is called Oyu-Tolgoi, which is about providing copper and gold concentrate primarily for the Chinese smelter. So that's where we are today. Let me start with the US. I was in the USA last week. You know, Rio Tinto has been in the USA for 145 years. We've been mining in the US, in California, for 145 years. We met with a series of officials of the Trump administration in Washington, D.C. last week. It's clearly early days. You know, we are monitoring the situation very carefully. It's fair to say that if the administration does what they said they would do in terms of investing in infrastructure in the USA, that could be very good for our business. We are providing copper, we are providing borates, we are providing aluminium as an example to the US market. So any investment in infrastructure should be good for us. In relation to other topics, including the question of the trades, you know, it's very early days, but what I've seen clearly first and last week is all the people we met were really had a strong business sense, let's see what happens. So I think it's going to be important to judge the Trump administration not too much on their words, but on their actions on the ground. Now, the second question was about China. If you ask me, am I concerned about the Chinese economy for 2017? The answer is no, I'm not concerned at all. It is absolutely clear that the Chinese government is taking actions in order to make sure that they meet their growth target. The premier has been very clear about what they are, and everything we see today in terms of infrastructure investment, in terms of construction market as an example, is moving in the right direction. So am I concerned about 2017? The answer, as I said, is no. We already have some of ships on our own, but the intention is not to build a stronger fleet for Rio Tinto. I think there is plenty of charter capacity in the marketplace, and the market is very efficient, and therefore we don't see the need for us to invest in this part of the supply chain. Yeah, so we need to step back. There are multiple drivers to support the price formation for iron ore. The first one that we just mentioned is about the health of the Chinese economy, and I'm not concerned about it at all. The second one is about the steel restructuring in China on the back of pollution and environmental issues. I believe that could create some opportunities for producers like Rio Tinto, because for people to be able to produce the same quantum of steel, they will have to buy higher quality iron ore, and that's where it's a good opportunity for us. The third driver is really around additional capacity in Brazil or in Australia, but I believe it's totally priced into the market today. The fourth driver, which is an uncertainty today, and that may create some volatility in the marketplace, is the production of iron ore in China, the domestic production in China. As we all know that a few years ago, China did produce slightly more than 400 million tons. We believe that today it's around 270 million tons. And with the current high prices, one could make an assumption that some of those mines which are currently in care and maintenance could restart, but today it's very difficult to read the situation. So what it means for Rio Tinto doesn't change is we need to master to control what we can control, which is really for us about the cost position of our assets. It's about the quality of our product, and it's the quality about the relationship with our Chinese customers to make sure that we can supply what they need in order to be able to produce the steel that China is requiring. Last year, I was 5 times in China, and this year we are in March, and I've already been twice in China. So, I've been here quite often. I don't know how many times I'm going to come to China this year, but I have a feeling that it will be more than 5 years. So I really enjoy it. It's always a great time. Last time I was here was 3 weeks ago, and what was fantastic is I was in Beijing, but I was in Shanghai. That gave me the opportunity to celebrate Chinese New Year with our strong team in Shanghai. You know, we have around 200 people in China, and that was a great experience to meet with their families. And the other piece, which was fantastic, was to meet directly with some of our customers in the Shanghai area. So each time I come here, I really enjoy it. Wow, that's a very good question. The priority number one for Rio is always safety. And we're putting lots of work and lots of effort in relation to safety. We have made good progress, but we still have some way to go. And the second very important item on the agenda is we've got more than 50,000 employees in Rio Tinto, and it's very important that they all understand what we're trying to achieve, that we need to step up our performance to deliver the right product to our customers. So really what is in the back of my mind every day when I wake up is really around how can we motivate those people to make sure that they do an even better job, safer job today than they did yesterday.